Assalamu alaikum, my name is Sayyed Faizan Kazmi. Currently enrolled in Doctor of Pharmacy program at University of Central Punjab. Today I am going to discuss about a drug amphetamine. So let's move towards the basic introduction of amphetamine. Amphetamine is a CNS stimulant. Amphetamine is a synthetic substance which acts as a stimulant of central nervous system. First manufactured in 1880s by German chemist Leuckart, they are derived from Ephedra sinica, which is native to China and Mongolia. The plant contains ephedrine and pseudoephedrine, which are natural alkaloids. They belong from a family of phenethylamine. IUPAC name is N-alpha-methylbenzenethylamine. Isomers can be separated into two isomers, levoamphetamine and dextroamphetamine. As you see in the structure of amphetamine on screen, molecular formula is CNH13N. It can be synthesized by two methods, Leuckart method and Friedal alkylation method. In first, we use phenylacetone and agents such as formic acid, formamide to yield a racemic mixture of R and S enantiomer. Whereas in second method, Friedal alkylation of benzene by allyl chloride to yield beta chloropropyl benzene, which is then reacted with ammonia to produce racemic amphetamine. Now moving towards the pharmacokinetics of amphetamine. Absorption: amphetamine is well absorbed in gut. Distribution: amphetamine are distributed into body tissues, especially in the brain and CSF. Metabolism: metabolized in liver by CYP2D6. Amphetamine is eliminating via the urine. Now moving towards the mechanism. Amphetamine is transported by monoamine reuptake transporters. Amphetamine inhibit VMAT2 that store the dopamine in vesicles, so more dopamine release in synapse. Amphetamine inhibit reuptake of dopamine through DAT phosphorylation. It also act AC in MAO inhibitor that metabolize the dopamine. Therapeutic effects: ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, is a condition in which people can seem restless. Narcolepsy is a chronic sleep disorder in which person can sudden feels the attack of sleep. Obesity: the work in the brain to reduce appetite and treat obesity. Adverse effect: CNS effect. The adverse effect of amphetamine usage include insomnia, irritability, weakness, dizziness, tremor, and hyperactive reflexes. In cardiovascular effects, amphetamine may cause palpitation, cardiac arrhythmias, hypertension, and anginal pain. In gastrointestinal effect, acts on GI system causing anorexia, nausea, vomiting, abdominal cramps. Now, moving towards the toxicity of amphetamine. Toxicity refers to overdose of a drug in bloodstream. Amphetamine toxicity should be suspected with diaphoresis, hypertension, and the patients having intestinal obstruction. Overdose of amphetamine, 6.4 mg per liter is the main lethal serum concentration. Now, drug-drug interaction. Amphetamine with antidepressant increase the risk of heartbeat, whereas amphetamine with BP drugs are sympathetic, resulting in hypertension. Whereas if we take amphetamine with stomach acid drugs, that decrease the stomach acid such as antacid and may increase the level of amphetamine. Moving towards the treatment by using amphetamine. Now moving towards the treatment. Benzodiazepine, diazepam, lorazepam, antipsychotics such as hydralazine and labetalol are used as the amphetamine drugs to treat the diseases. I am really thankful to my colleagues for their contribution. That's all about amphetamine. My colleagues are Aisha Amin, Kinza Kaleem, Aisha Aslam, and myself, Sayyed Faizan Kazim. Thank you.